Hi everyone and welcome back to another fun card making video. Today I'm going to play with photo stamps. Photo stamps is a huge category by Darkroom Door. You will find a huge variety of images. They are photos that are turned into stamps. And since this is not just a design with an outline and it is a photo with actual shading and lots of details, it is made out of rubber, so it grabs all those details. The designs are really unique and you will be able to find a huge variety of them on Darkroom Door, and I'm going to leave a link down below. But for today I have three of them as an example and I'm going to show you how I like to work with them. Of course these are cling stamps, so if you peel off the backing you will be able to stick them on your acrylic block or your stamping platform. What I like to do with these stamps is to pick a focal point, cut it out and color it completely separately and then pop it on top of the actual photo, and I'm going to show you what I mean with the three examples. So first I'm going to stamp my image and I'm starting with a football stamp. I know this is soccer for my US friends, but we call it football and this is actually called football, this stamp. Anyway, I'm going to stamp that with black archival ink on white cardstock. I'm making sure that I have a good contact and then you will see that it grabs all those details, even the shading. I'm super happy with the impression. I'm not going to stamp it a second time on top, but I am going to stamp it one more time on a separate piece of paper so that I can use my scissors to cut out the main focal image later on. For adding color on my images, I'm going to work with distress ink, and here I'm using the new color. This is Salvaged Patina. This is a new color to me and the new to the collection. I haven't used it before, so today I'm going to use it on all three of the cards just to see different color combinations and how it works with other colors. If you go ahead and use the good old blending tools with the round foam, you will find that it adds a color easier. Here I have to load my brush again and again to get a good saturation of color, but I prefer that because I don't want to oversaturate the color. I like to add thinner layers until I'm happy with the outcome. I'm also going to add a darker shade of blue in some areas so that it doesn't look so flat. And I don't mind if I go over the ball, after all I'm going to cover it up later on. I'm also going to add some green on the grass. And of course you can color your image with any of your favorite coloring medium. You can go with your alcohol markers, you can even stamp that on watercolor paper and use your watercolors. Just go with whatever makes you happy. Now, since the photo stamp does have all that detail on the grass, I don't even need to go with a second color to add shading on the grass. The shading is already there. Now, where that green and blue meet, there is no problem at all, since green and blue match nicely together and they don't create mud. I am going for a vintage look and feel today, that's why I am adding some vintage photo all around, but this is a step that you don't have to do if you don't want to. You can keep it nice and bright as it was before. Also, I happen to have this text stamp by Darkroom Door that is all about sports and champion. It has words like that. And I'm going to use that just to add some text at the top so that it doesn't look that empty. And at the same time, it adds something extra on the vintage look that I'm going for. What I love about the designs of the photo stamps is that they are both masculine and feminine. So you can use them for any occasion. And it so happens that my son has been playing football and is on a team for quite some time now. And honestly, this is the perfect stamp that I could ever find to make a card for him. Now, I did stamp that a second time and fuzzy cut the ball along with the foot. And now, with my tool, I'm going to add a curve on the ball. I'm going to make it dimensional. I'm using this stylus tool that has a big ball on the edges. And I'm just taking my time, making sure that it's going to look nice and round at the end. Then I can add some foam tape at the back and stick it directly on top of my panel. And here you can see the photo stamp and how I turned it dimensional by fuzzy cutting the focal point and popping it on top. And I'm not sure if you can tell that the ball is actually rounded. So I'm happy with how this panel looks at the moment. I'm going to leave it aside and I'm going to work on the second photo stamp. I'm going to create all three of the panels and then I will turn them all into cards. This photo stamp is called Electric Guitar, and of course the moment you see that you know which the focal point is going to be. I'm going to pop the electric guitar. Again, I'm going to follow the exact same technique as I did for the first card. I'm going to stamp this a couple of times so that once I can use it as a background and also fuzzy cut the focal point. Again, I'm going to use my black archival ink. This is jet black archival ink. Again, I got a good impression. I'm not going to stamp it a second time on top. I absolutely love how I get darker and lighter areas. It helps on the shading later on. So I'm going to leave it as it is and I'm going to stamp it one more time on a different piece of paper. For coloring again, I'm going to do some blending. Again, I'm using my Distress inks. For the background, since I'm going again for a vintage look and feel, I'm going with browns. But of course you can follow any color combination that you like and with any coloring medium. Now here I was kind of masking off the amplifier as I was planning to leave it as it is, but you will see later on that I'm going to change my mind and I'm going to use the amplifier as well as the guitar as my focal points. And of course at this point I have to say that I chose the photo stamps based on the hobbies of the people in my house. So my husband and my daughter do play the electrical guitar. My son is playing football all the time. And then again, I couldn't stay away from the third stamp, which is all about gardening, because who doesn't love flowers? But trust me, the variety of those photo stamps is so big that if you go to the darkroom door category, you will find lots and lots of different options, all so unique, and I'm sure you will find something for you. Photo stamps are also great for mixed media. You can do something similar and instead of sticking the panel on top of a card base, you can stick it on top of a page in a mini art journal. So this is where I stamped that for a second time. That was with a black archival ink, but again I'm going to stamp it one more time on top and this time I'm using pigment ink. This is black pigment ink, which is going to be very very dark. Once I stamp that you will see what I mean. I'm going for the amplifier focal point here. So since I'm using pigment ink, it doesn't dry really quickly. And I'm able to apply on top my clear embossing powder. This way my focal point is going to turn nice and shiny and it's going to really make a statement on top of my card. So here I'm using my heat gun, I'm going to melt the clear embossing powder and then I'm going to fuzzy cut only that square, the square where the amplifier is. At this stage I don't care about the electrical guitar, I just want to have the amplifier. Then I'm going to use foam tape at the back and stick it on top of my background. And you can see already how it brings that image to life. I'm going to repeat the same process one more time, this time for the guitar. Again stamped with black pigment ink, applying on top clear embossing powder and heat set it. I'm going to fuzzy cut only the white part of the guitar. And I don't want the guitar to be black on black, where you have a black guitar on top of a black amplifier to help it pop against the background. I'm going to use some color for that. And since I wanted to play with the new Distress Line color, again I'm going to color my actual electrical guitar with salvaged patina. This time instead of stamping on white cardstock, I am using off-white, this is vanilla cardstock. And I don't like how bright it is at the moment. I want to have that vintage look on this card as well. So I'm going to add a touch of vintage photo. I'm going to apply that on my stamp just by using the blending tool. Just a touch is going to do the job. And again, just like my amplifier, I want the guitar to be nice and shiny. That's why I'm going to use my embossing ink. Then on top you can go either with clear embossing powder so you can get that color from underneath, but instead I'm going to go with embossing glaze, the same color as the ink that I used, just to see how it works. This embossing glaze is transparent, so although it's going to add an extra tint of the same color, you will be able to see underneath what is going on. So I'm not going to cover up completely the whole design. And once I heat set that, I'm going to fuzzy cut again the part of the guitar that I want. So it's finally time to put the guitar together, just sticking one part on top of the other. And then again I'm going to use foam tape at the back and pop it on top of my card. Lots of dimension on this card as I have two layers and lots of shine that really brings that image to life. You can do that trick with the black embossing if you want on the ball as well. And finally, I have the third example for you. This time I'm going with the planted sunflowers, and I picked the sunflower as well as the gardening glove to be my focal points here. So these are the ones that I'm going to pop. Again, I'm going to stamp the whole image so that I can color it for my background. And then stamp it a couple more times so that I can cut out the extra focal points. For the gardening glove, I decided to go with salvaged patina. Then for the daisy, I'm going to add a touch of yellow and orange at the center, leaving mainly the tips of the petals white. And for coloring all the focalipanges as well as the background that has lots and lots of details, I switch between different blending tools that I have available, from larger brushes to super tiny ones. But if it makes it easier for you, just go with your alcohol markers or even your brush and your watercolors. So here I'm just cutting out a couple of leaves, and I'm making sure that this is bigger than the actual leaf so that I can tuck it underneath the dimensional flower. And finally, here it is with the magic of video editing, where the whole background is already colored and all I have to do is to stick the focal points on top by using foam tape at the back. I'm also going to stick down the gardening glove, and I'm going to call this one done. And if you want, you can add some glaze at the center of the sunflower, and there are many other ways that you can enhance this image even more. So here are all the three panels that I made for today using the same technique by cutting out focal points and turning them dimensional. All three of them can be turned into art journals, they can be tags, they can be ATCs, whatever. I'm going to turn them into cards, and they would go perfectly on a vanilla card base, on a black one, or even a craft one. And I'm going to stick one of them on those three different choices so that you can see how they look. All these cards would make great Father's Day cards, and I have this stamp set that is full of Father's Day sentiments, perfect for the occasion. If you want to use that, and I'm going to link it down below. However, for these specific cards, I decided to go with sticker sentiments, but really these are very versatile, you can use any sentiment that you like. So here are all the three cards that I made for today, ready to go. If you are looking for a unique design for your stamp collection, I think you should check out the Photo Stamp Collection by Darkroom Door. I'm sure you will find amazing designs. Just like always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area, as well as a link to the Darkroom Door photo stamp collection. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for spending some time with me today, and I'll see you all on Mixed Media Tuesday.